Hello and welcome back. To set up a new Sanity project, first go to sanity.io and click on Get Started. Here, you have a command that is already available for you. The first part of the command will install Sanity globally for you, while the last part will create a new Sanity application for you. I already have Sanity installed globally on my machine, so I'll just go ahead and run the last command to create a new Sanity project. First, I'll make a new directory. And here, I can run my Sanity init command. If you do not already have a Sanity account, it will ask you to create a new account or to log into your existing account. I already do have an account, so I can go ahead and create a new project by selecting Create New Project and clicking Enter. Here, you can give your Sanity project a name. I will call it Sanity Mission. Yes. The output part is correct. So these are existing sample schemas that Sanity provides. If you do want to start with a blank schema, you have the option to do that. But I'll go ahead and use the e-commerce sample schema just so that I have some sample data to work with for a start. Yes, so that we can have some sample products in our schema to work with. So our Sanity application has been created successfully. What I want to do next, open it up in Visual Studio Code and show you what the initial folder structure looks like. I'm particularly interested in showing you two files, the sanity.json file and the schemas folder. So open it up in Visual Studio Code. So if you look at the Sanity Mission project and check sanity.json file, here, the dataset is set according to our specification. It can be called development or anything else you'd like to call your dataset. But in my case, I'll go ahead and use the production dataset. You also have the project ID, which can help you connect your Sanity application to a front end, as we will do in the later stages of this mission. And the name of the project is Sanity Mission, as we specified earlier. These are all default files that came with the e-commerce schema. I will show you what they look like in the Sanity Studio, but in the meantime, just know that these are all just sample data that are created by default for us to work with. So let's go ahead and look at Sanity Studio. Run Sanity Start to start the Sanity development server. I'm in the wrong directory. I have to move into the project directory. And now I can run Sanity Start. Copy this to the browser. Once again, I'll log in with the same account I used to create the Sanity application. So we have a functional Sanity project. It has a few contents by default based on the e-commerce schema we selected. The first one is the product that we need for our e-commerce application. Here we have a search bar that allows you to search for any content in your production dataset. And here we have the vision tab, which you can click to search for any product or run any queries in this dataset. For instance, you can run queries to fetch all the products that are available in your project. And we can do that just by clicking the Run Query button. And with that, we've come to the end of this lesson about setting up a Sanity application and introducing you to Sanity Studio. In the next lesson, we'll go ahead and discuss schemas in more detail and also show you how to create them. We'll also look at document types and how they work together in Sanity. See you there.